Hello, you guys. Welcome to another episode, the 50th episode. Hold on, I'll get to that in a second, of Coffee with Corey. I'm Corey Cohen. I'm Vice President of Partner Experience at TBI, who is a technology services distributor. And every week since COVID, I introduce you to a technology supplier, and we talk about obviously technology, but really just about life. But you guys, this is my 50th episode. What? 50. Yeah. I love me a good, I love me some Molly Shannon. She's so funny. Thanks Jim for finding that. I'm really excited for my guest today, but I want to talk about a few things. So, we all know that I'm not like a huge fan of working from home just because like my kids bother me a lot. And it's really hard to be both worker and mom worker at the same time. They're constantly like, will you eat lunch with me? No, I'm on a call. Like I can't. But I have found that, I mean, I'm getting this like work from home thing down pat just as we're about to like go back into the office and do some hybrid scheduling. And I have found that I'm actually able to go to like doctor's appointments. One of them being the dentist, which sad to say, I very much neglect. I just don't do it because I don't like the dentist. But in COVID in the last like couple months, I've had to go 3 times. Why? One for a regular cleaning. But then the other time was for, I needed a new mouth guard. Now, I think dental insurance is a racket because they did not cover this. And do you know what I did? Do you know what I had to do? I had to spend $1,600 on a new mouth guard. I can't believe I'm actually going to do this on the 50th episode, but I'm going to show it to you. This is my mouth guard. I've never had anything like this before. This is what a 40-year-old mom has to deal with. This is what $1,600 gets you that insurance doesn't cover. It's really annoying. I look amazing. I can't believe I did that, you know? And show that to you. It's pretty gross. I should do the whole show this way. Yeah, can you believe that this is happening? Meanwhile, yeah, it's a good point because it's the 50th show. Someone gets a $50 gift card to Starbucks. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks for having coffee with me. Definitely shouldn't drink and use my amazing mouth guard. Not like I could actually do that. I'd probably like spit all over. All right, let's get into it because I'm just bitter about the $1,600 that insurance didn't cover for a mouth guard. Moving forward. All right, you guys, I am really excited to introduce my new friend, Andre Van Zyl. It took me a while to try to figure out how to do his last name, but Andre, he is head of channel at Cologix. And Andre, thanks for joining me today.
What's good, Corey?
Nothing, I love. So, okay, a couple things.
Just hold on before you carry on. That mouth guard reminds me of the Ellen DeGeneres show where they put those things in their mouths. They're supposed to say certain words. You can just rock up in the show and just bring your mouth guard.
I mean, it's like I have my own Ellen DeGeneres show. I'm going to compare myself to the amazing Ellen. Yeah, that's not great. A few things. I love having you on this show because I could just listen to your accent all day long, right? You're South African.
Yes.
But you don't reside in South Africa. I don't even know what time it would be there right now.
Jeez, I hail from South Africa, but I'm currently here in Denver, Colorado. It's probably sometime in the late afternoon in South Africa. It's actually beer o'clock in South Africa.
It is beer o'clock or scotch o'clock. We'll get into that in a second. So talk to me, because you are in Denver and it is an hour earlier, not like you need any excuse to drink coffee because you are a new dad. What are you drinking with me today?
So I'm a big Starbucks buff. Today I've got my Venti Pike that I've poured into my trust Cologix Cup. This is my second one though, so I'm feeling pretty good.
You're not at your house though right now. You're at an...
No, I'm in my little rental office. Since COVID, we had to shut down a few things, but with a crying baby, I needed to pop out of the office, or the home office, and come here to a quiet place to get some work done.
So let's talk about this. You have a baby girl, Kaylee, mm-hmm. right?
Kaylee, baby Kaylee.
Baby Kaylee, how old is baby Kaylee?
Today, she is a whole 6 weeks.
A freshie.
Brand new.
Brand spanking new. Yeah. You look remarkable. Like, how are you functioning?
I think it's the coffee, to be honest. I thought it's perseverance. I just push through.
Yeah, it's not getting easier, buddy.
I believe so.
Well, that's amazing. So you have a new baby. That's fantastic. It's quite a change. Yeah, it's like
it's a roller coaster, I'll tell you. I think the best way that I can explain having or being a new dad, it's literally like going on a safari ride in South Africa. First, you don't sleep while you're on the safari ride. And second, you got to pay attention. You got to like look out, and you never know what's going to be around the next bush, whether it's a lion or an elephant or a rhino. That's basically what I think about when I check my daughter's diaper. I don't know what's going to come out of that diaper.
Yeah. I like, yeah. I love, so, you know, Jim, our production manager, is behind StreamYard and behind the show, and he has, you know, twins in addition, mm-hmm. twin babies in addition to a three-year-old, and I think he really, really appreciates you basically creating the analogy of being new dad to babies as like going on a safari. I do think that Jim thinks his kids are actually trying to kill him. Like a lion.
that is what their instincts are for the first 8 weeks of their life.
Yeah, I mean, they are
I want to irritate my mom and dad as much as possible.
Oh, yeah. No, I know they are. It's the beginning is like, I don't know. I'm not a big newborn fan, but because, you know, they're kind of just like, this is going to sound bad. They're just like parasites. They sleep, they poop, they eat. Repeat all the time.
Yeah. Every 3 hours.
Yeah. So I don't know. It definitely gets better. Although it is nice when they're immobile and you're just able to like make dinner and that, you know, the baby's just like on the ground looking at a mobile or something, you know?
I just strap the kid in, then I can go to the fridge, have a beer, have some dinner. And when she starts getting a little crazy, then I'll go back and check on her.
Yeah. I mean, you totally
have this. Like, she's going to be running around. So it's going to be a different scenario.
Yeah. You have this like down pat, it seems.
That's it.
So, okay, as much as I would love to talk about baby Kaylee like the entire time, and I actually really do, I think we should talk a little bit about Cologix. Who are you guys? What do you do?
Very easy. We are a network neutral colocation provider. We operate over 30 data centers in the US and Canada. Just a nice one simple one-liner.
It honestly, just say more. I could listen to this accent all day long. How long have you been there?
So I'm one of the old guys. I have been, this is my seventh year at Cologix. So I actually started there in 2014. Back then, I think we only had 9 data centers. We're still a very new company. And I guess I always tell the story to some of the new folks who joined Cologix, and they never believe me. But when I joined Cologix in 2014, I was fresh off the bus from Vancouver. Came to Toronto to start as a sales rep for this up-and-coming co-location company. And I guess at that stage, I'd been in the industry for 11, 12-odd years in the data center side. So I thought I knew a thing or two. But I was in a bit of a shock. After my first day, I had a few beers with our boss at that time, Sean Mascal. On day two, we had to go and start selling. And at that stage, I had two big problems. One, nobody knew who Cologix was. The name didn't exist in Canada. It was a known brand. So we had to go around and explain to people what it is we do. And then when they heard the term co-location, they're like, what is that? And I guess after a few weeks, me and the team, we came up with a new term that we actually sell IT real estate. And that started getting a couple of conversations going. So 7 years ago, very different company, but now it's a different brand.
And I mean, yeah, you've been there quite a bit. And so I'm curious.
And this is our 10th year. So Cologix turned 10 this year.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah.
That is some great milestones. You guys turned 10, TBI turned 30. This is my 50th episode. I mean, this is just magic, magical. Out of curiosity though, why am I like screaming? I feel like I'm screaming. Out of curiosity, I like you telling the story of how you had to explain who Cologix is and then also what Colo is. But the market's obviously matured a bit. I'm not going to say like totally matured. What have you seen from then till now? Like, talk about what you're seeing now.
Yeah, so I guess for Cologix specifically, we haven't changed or redirected our strategy. We have added to our strategy. So, 10 years ago, when we first started, we were building our data centers and buying data centers at these carrier dense hotels where we all know that connectivity is key and is the biggest differentiator when it comes to co-location. So back then we were more of a called a retail data center setting, one cabinet, two cabinets. And I guess as time went by, we started seeing the cloud service providers really making a big run at this industry. And a lot of these enterprise-type customers started adopting a cloud-first solution. Mm-hmm. So while we were, up and coming, we had, the right footprint for these cloud service providers to offer their service out of our data centers. After some time, we actually started realizing that there was two strategies here at play where we needed to serve cloud service providers in a large hyperscale deployment solution, as well as service smaller enterprise customers through our carrier hotels. So what's changed for us is that we now offer large hyperscale data centers, 10 megawatts up to 100 megawatt facilities, as well as then we provide carrier connectivity through these annex sites at our carrier hotels. So the biggest thing that's changed is companies or enterprises aren't just coming just deploying a one box solution, that's everything. They're coming deploying hybrid solutions. Mm-hmm. So now our solutions in our business are able to offer these services to all companies. So that's been the biggest change, going from one little box to a hybrid solution.
Oh, I love that answer. So true when you're talking about the dual strategy approach and how you're kind of able to service both the CSPs, but also just like companies of all sizes with a cloud first mm-hmm. approach. And I think that's important to talk about, especially as we haven't been in the office for over 365 days, but also as we're kind of coming back and as companies are figuring out their next move, their strategy, they've made some cloud transitions, but they're going to embark on further transformation, if you will. So if you could share with me kind of like your focus for this year on how you're going to enable some of these companies to make a cloud business, the cloud first approach?
Yeah, well, I guess if I look at it from a Cologix perspective, again, our focus right now is to expand our hyperscale reach. We have acquired some land in Ashburn, in which we've actually started constructing a large hyperscale data center. We are expanding our services in Columbus by building out a fourth hyperscale data center there too. It's really become, the next Ashburn of
yeah.
As well as we've just made our first acquisition in Silicon Valley, we acquired an old carrier dense facility that offers multiple megawatts solutions with expansion plans also. So our focus right now is to continue to build out our hyperscale reach, give it a pure pan-US presence as well as a pure Canadian presence, offering these hyperscale solutions throughout all the regions, and then tethering back to our carrier hotels and offering our enterprise customers the ability to connect, the fastest way to connect into these hyperscale service providers.
That's a lot. I mean, you guys are making significant moves. That's exciting. Could you maybe, I'm interested to know what kind of are the biggest changes you guys experienced this past year? Because I feel like Cologix made some moves. What were they?
Yeah, look, I think we've been aggressive in the acquisition markets. The last 3 years, we've made four new acquisitions. But on top of that, I think the biggest development on our side is we have developed our own software-defined marketplace, which we refer to as our Cologix Access Marketplace. In short, I'm not the smart guy to talk about this. I'll just give you the high level. There's other folks that can talk about this in detail. But basically what this solution is, we can enable our customers to connect into any cloud service provider, actually any customer that is available in that ecosystem out of any data center that they operate in today. It's not a white labeled service. It's something that we actually built from the ground up. We have a dedicated team here in Denver that started this and built it. It's up and running. It's been live for at least a year or two now, and it's been a real hit for us. So that's been the biggest event for us. Cologix Cloud Access Marketplace.
Awesome. For those more interested, you can reach out directly to just do marketing at tbicom.com, and we will put you in touch with Cologix around that. I think the real burning question, though, people want to know, maybe not necessarily about Cologix, but perhaps about you, is what's the deal with the hot sauce in the corner? Is it Frank's? I'm curious.
My boss is going to love that. I don't know what it is, but I love hot sauce.
I do too.
I like that ad. You got to put that shit on everything. I put it on everything. Literally, eggs, dinners, whatever.
You almost did maybe to a split take. I do put that shit on everything.
Literally, there's not a meal that goes by. And my father-in-law loves saying this to me. He's like, do you want some eggs with that hot sauce? Like, there's more hot sauce on my plate than there is any other food. So it just, I have to have it where it is. I've got a big bottle here too, right next to me.
So to be clear, now you actually have to come visit me in Chicago because we share a love for scotch.
Yep.
Now it's hot sauce.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, bring Kaylee and your wife. Like, we're making a party with the cake.
What's your favorite hot sauce?
Lucy, the nanny, has turned me on to, I don't know the brand of it, but it's green and it is habanero hot sauce. You can find it. Most of the time I find it in the Hispanic section of the supermarket. It is awesome. I love it. Now I'm addicted. But I really do. Anyone who knows me knows that I can't really live without crushed red pepper. So for me, while it is hot sauce that I love, crushed red pepper is literally put on every single food item that I have. So there's that.
Love
the spice. Switching gears for a second. What are your hobbies? Like, what are you doing? Not right now, because you have Kaylee, but what would you do if you could do it?
Yeah, well, I love watching rugby. But my thing that I do to get out of the house and just to go and spend some time in the fresh air, I love playing golf. I'm a double digit handicap, so you can trust me. If I was a single digit, I wouldn't be a very good salesperson. But I love golf. Since being here in Denver, I can play almost year round. And it's my breakaway.
Yeah, it is. It's I don't play, but my husband does. And he's always trying to get me to do it. And then I think he realized maybe it's great that we have separate interests. Like, maybe he's given up, right? Because I'm not going to do it. I don't really want to venture down something that I'm not good at. I like to win. I'm competitive. And then it doesn't seem like I'm going to just take up something new right now.
I get it. I've been playing this game for like 20 years. I don't win very often. So I wouldn't just take it up if it just to lose.
So okay, obviously the whole reason why I do this show is, what are you binge watching on TV?
Well, right now I'm binge watching anything, but yeah. before 6 weeks ago, over the last 9 months really, there's been four shows that I've watched. Number one was Your Honor.
Okay.
Which is Mr. Walter White from Breaking Bad. Great show. That was riveting. I then also got into Westworld.
Yes,
Westworld. I was actually trying to watch Yellowstone, but I kept Googling Westworld for some reason. Very weird. Lots of weird naked robots all over the show. But it was riveting. We couldn't stop watching it.
Okay.
And then I got into Yellowstone after that. Great story. Love Kevin Costner ever since back in the day from Robin Hood days. Mm-hmm. Always been a big fan of his productions.
You told me about Yellowstone, and now you're like the fourth person that told me. So I've started. I'm on episode 5 because I only get one episode a night.
Yep.
To watch. It's really good.
It's amazing. It's infectious.
Yeah.
But the last one that I would say everybody has to watch this is Ted Lasso.
Yep.
It's on Apple TV. I think we watched the entire season in like 3 days.
Okay.
Ted Lasso is a American college football coach. He gets dragged over to the UK to coach a Premier League division or Division II soccer team. And he has no clue what he's doing, but he has this infectious optimism about everything. And he just turns the team around, just turns the people around him. And you just can't wait for the next piece of optimism to come out of his mouth. So I'd recommend all you guys, go and watch that show.
Okay. I mean, obviously you're not the only person who has said that. I'll bite the bullet and do and pay for something else.
$6. It's just $6.
I know. I just signed up for Paramount Plus. It's like, what I'm doing. I'm such a sucker too. Okay. Let's end. I know you actually have, from a personal standpoint, a lot to look forward to this year, seeing baby Kaylee grow. But what are some other things you're looking forward to this year?
Yeah, so obviously seeing Kaylee walk for the first time is going to be the biggest thing for us.
Wow.
But I guess for me professionally, it's for me and my team, we can't wait to get on a plane. Mm-hmm. And actually go and visit some of our partners. We love being top of mind, love being in person and having a beverage or going for lunch or just attending a conference with some of our partners. I think that's the biggest thing for us. And we're hoping maybe next month, maybe in the next 2 months, we can be released, get on a plane and actually start seeing some folks. That's the number one thing that we're looking forward to. The other thing is, personally, I want to break 80 in a round of golf this year. It's a big challenge.
Yeah.
But I think maybe this is the year.
Okay. We can try to assist and help. Mm-hmm. Yes, getting back on a plane, I totally want to do as well. In the Canadian market, it's hard. They're really strict mm-hmm. right now. Like you can't go to Canada.
You can't go to Canada. Well, you can if you wanted to, but you got to go in quarantine for 2 weeks in a hotel. I've actually got my family from Vancouver with us right now. They had to quarantine. They came here. They were back here in December. It costs you thousands of dollars to fly back and then go in quarantine in a hotel and not do anything. So it's miserable to travel to that.
I know. We're running out of time, but we're trying to get up to this like lodge. It's called Severn Lodge. It's near Muskoka. It's beautiful. It's where I got engaged.
Wow.
And I'm dying to take my kids there. But yeah.
How big are the mosquitoes there?
I don't remember the mosquitoes, but maybe it was because I was in like the honeymoon phase, you know, like I was so like la la that I just like didn't pay attention.
Everything was hunky dory.
Everything
the
was
mosquitoes hunky-dory. Are like that size. Like
I mean, massive. Mosquitoes love me. Like I apparently have the sweetest blood to them. Plus, it's horrible. I don't know. I would maybe not go because of that, actually.
You need either more scotch or more hot sauce. They'll leave you alone.
It doesn't, trust me, that is what runs through my blood. Yeah, still don't care. Anyway, Andre, this has been fab. Thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it. And sharing more about Cologix and yourself. You guys, like I said, more interested in more information about Cologix, please email marketing@tbicom.com. And thanks for joining our 50th episode. Andre, thanks for being my guest. And I'll see you hopefully soon.
Awesome, Corey. Thanks.